I wanted to hook those to the chain plates. Is that all right? I saw it there. Yep. It won't be permanent, but they're okay.
Yeah, they're fine.
All right.
They're all good. My plan was once you're like in and I've taken like 90% of the weight off, I was just going to leave it, shut the machine down, and let you guys get everything where you want it, and then I'll take that last.
That's fine.
Just to have a safety.
Yeah. Stepping the mast went really well. We were pretty well prepped for it. We had a really good crew. We had a really good day. Pretty much went without a hitch. We had the rig ready and temporary shrouds. We had temporary masts, wedges ready. Crane operations were really smooth. And it was pretty quick. It's a pretty quick process. More time was spent in the morning dressing the mast, which is the process of putting all of the rigging on the mast, making sure that everything was organized and tight and that there wouldn't be anything, kind of flopping around in the wind as the mast got picked or once it went in. You know, you want to make sure all that rigging is organized. And it's pretty easy day. I would say what's next is to continue securing the standing rigging for the main mast, the shrouds, the forestay. There's a stay called a false stay. That's going to take some time making the lower ends of the shrouds off, which is called turning back the shrouds to the dead eyes, which allow the shrouds to be tuned or tightened to the hull. The bowsprit will go in, which can kind of happen now or later, and will be held into position by the jib stay and to some degree stabilized by what's called the gammoning lashing. And then the top mast will go up probably a little bit later. I'd like to get the main mast totally secure. That's kind of what we're looking at for the next few weeks.